press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students, today we are going to discuss the first poem of your class 3 English, that is Good Morning. Good morning, it sounds very familiar, right? Okay, when will you say good morning? When you wake up early in the morning, you will say good morning to all your family members, right? Your parents, your members, your family members, your neighbors. What will you say? Good morning. Yes. When your class teacher enters your class, you wish her as good morning teacher, right? Like this, good morning is considered as a morning wish. The very first poem of your class 3 English book, that is Marigold, is Good Morning. And this poem is written by Fanny R. Baccarano. Who is the poet of this poem? He is Fanny R. Baccarano. Okay. In this poem, the poet says that a child wishes good morning to everyone in the surrounding out there. Do you understand? The child wishes good morning to the everyone in the surrounding out there. Okay. Let's start this poem. Okay. All of you having your textbook? Yes. Textbooks are very necessary in language classes. Okay. Please bring along with you when you are listening this class. Okay. Let's start this poem. It is a very simple and beautiful poem. Okay. Let's start this. When I'm reading, please go through it. Good morning. Good morning, sky. Good morning, sun. Good morning, little winds that run. Good morning, birds. Good morning, trees and creeping grass and brownie bees. How did you find out it was a day? Who told you night had gone away? I'm wide awake. I'm up now too. I'll be right out to play with you. Yes, it is a very simple and beautiful poem. As I told earlier, a child wishes good morning to everyone in surrounding out there. Okay, firstly, it wishes good morning to the sky. Have you guys ever experienced the climate of the morning? Yes, when you wake up early in the morning, the sky is very beautiful and very bluish and very peaceful in nature. Do you understand? So, the child wishes good morning, firstly wishes good morning to the sky, like good morning sky. Understand? Next, good morning sun. Okay. Sun is the source of energy. Sun is the energy of light. Sun is the energy of life. When sun rises, we consider it is a day. And when sun disappears, we consider it is an night. Without sun, we can't imagine our life. When sun rises, all of us start doing our day-to-day work, right? Yes. So, the child also wishes good morning to that rising sun. Yes, in morning, the rising sun is reddish brown in color. It's very attractive in nature, right? Yes. The child secondly wishes good morning to that rising sun. And next, good morning, little winds that run. Yes. In morning, as I told earlier, in morning, a cold breeze is coming and it is passing through you, right? Yes, the wind is blowing peacefully and slowly. That little winds that run, they are running. The poet say, the child says that it is running in nature. The wind is running in nature. So, the child says good morning to that little winds. Next, the child says good morning to the birds. Yes, when the sun rises, the birds also awaken. They start searching their food. They are flying here and there. The chirruping birds sounds is very peaceful and very beautiful in nature, right? Yes, this child says good morning to those chirruping birds also. Do you understand? Next, good morning trees. Yes, In morning, the branches of trees are shuddering and the leaves are rustling. Rustling means shaking. Do you understand? Yes. The child wishes good morning to those trees and also and creeping grass and browny bees. What is the meaning of creeping? Creeping means slowly moving. Okay. Grass is slowly moving upwards. So, the child wishes good morning to that grass also and also browny bees. Yes. Browny bees are the most hard workers of the insect family. You know, na? Next. So, the brownie bees are also when sun rises, the brownie bees are also start their working. They collecting nectar from flower to flower and transferring them, right? And make a honey. So, the child wishes good morning to those brownie bees also. And next, after the wishing of good morning to everyone, it asking a question for those who it wishes. And the question was, how did you find out it was a day? Yes. The sun rises, the birds also chirping, the birds also awaken, and the grass is creeping, brownie bees are flying, right? The sky is bluish in color. How did they know that day was started? Yes. Who told? Who told you night had gone away? Do you understand? The child asking a question to those skies and little winds, birds, trees, that who told you that night had gone away? Yar helidru nimge night ratri mugitu ivagale belagaitu anta ee dina start aitu anta nimge heng gottaitu? ನಮಗೇನೋ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೇಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಪಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ಎಬ್ಬಿಸ್ತಾರೆ, ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾರು ಹೇಳಿದರು? ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯಿತು ಇದು ಡೇ ಅಂತ? ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ದ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್. ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್? ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ವೈಡ್ ಅವೇಕ್. ಯೆಸ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅವೇಕ್ ಅನ್ ನೌ. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಅಪ್ ನೌ ಟು. ಯೆಸ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗೆಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಯು. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರೈಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಟು ಪ್ಲೇ ವಿತ್ ಯು. ಯೆಸ್, ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಪ್ಲೇ ವಿತ್ ಯು. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಈಗರ್ಲಿ ವೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪ್ಲೇ ವಿತ್ ಯು. I will be right out to play with you. I will come to you to play with you. So, the child firstly wishes good morning to everyone in the surrounding out there by describing the beauty of the morning. ಬೆಳಗಿನ ಸುಂದರವಾದ ಚಿತ್ರಣವನ್ನು ವಿವರಿಸ್ಕೊಂತ ಆ ಒಂದು ಮಗು ತನಗೆ ಪ್ರಕೃತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಣುವಂಥ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ವಸ್ತುಗಳಿಗೂ ಮತ್ತು ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳಿಗೂ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ನ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಿದೆ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಸೇಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಕೈ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಲಿಟ್ಲ್ ವಿಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ರೀಪಿಂಗ್ ಗ್ರಾಸ್ ಬ್ರೌನಿ ಬೀಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿ ಆಫ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್, ರೈಟ್? ಯೆಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಪೋಯಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ನೋಟಿಸ್ ದಟ್? ಯೆಸ್, ದೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಕ್ರೀಪಿಂಗ್. Creeping means slowly moving, crawling, moving slowly. The grass is slowly moving upwards. Like this creeping is used. Next, awake. Awake means wake up. Wake up, get up, arise. Okay, and next, gone away. Gone away means go away. He gone away means he go away. Okay, these are the newest words in this poem and some of the nouns are there. What is the meaning of noun? Noun is the word which describes a man, a person, a place, a thing, right? Those nouns are sky. Can I write there? Okay. I will write here. Nouns are sky, sun, birds, trees, bees. Okay, these are the nouns. And eggs. Shall we go to some exercises? Okay. Reading is fun. Yes, reading is fun. Okay, there are three questions. Okay, first question is, why is the child in the poem happy? Why is the child is happy in the poem? Yes, it knows that night had gone away and it is a day. Do you understand? It's morning now and night has been over, so the child is happy. Okay, can you write the answer? That is, the child is happy because it is morning now and night has been over. Okay, so the child is happy. Second question is, to whom does the child say good morning? Okay, this question is, to whom the child wishes good morning? Yes, firstly it wishes sky, then it wishes sun, and then it wishes creeping grass, and also it wishes little winds, and then birds, trees, brownie bees, right? So sky, sun, wind, birds, trees, bees, grass, okay? For all this, it wishes good morning. This is the answer of second question. And third question is, what does the child want to do? Child, what does the child want to do is, play with birds and bees. In the last line, the child says that, I'll be right out to play with you. Play with whom? Play with birds. Play with bees. Do you understand? This is the answer for third question. All of you guys have finished? Okay. Next. It is clock time. Okay. In the morning, I say good morning. At night, I say good night. A dog says bow bow. A cow says moo moo. Okay. ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ, ನೈಟ್ ಗುಡ್ ನೈಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ರಾತ್ರಿ ಆದಾಗ ಒಂದು ನಾಯಿ ಬೌ ಬೌ ಅಂತ ಬೊಗಳುತ್ತೆ, ಮತ್ತು ಒಂದು ಹಸು ಮೂ ಮೂ ಅಂತ ಕೂಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದೇ ಥರ ನೀವು ನಿನ್ನ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸಿಗೆ ಯಾವ ಥರ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೀರಾ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮತ್ತು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ ಥರ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಈ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಇದೆ. ಸೇ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಓನ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಹೌ ವಿಲ್ ಯು ವಿಶ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್? ಯೆಸ್, ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್. ಇಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ನೇಹ, ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ನೇಹ. ಇಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ರಾಮ್, ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ರಾಮ್, ರೈಟ್? ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಯುವರ್ ಟೀಚರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಹೌ ವಿಲ್ ಯು ವಿಶ್ ಅ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಟೀಚರ್? ಯೆಸ್, ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟೀಚರ್, ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್, ರೈಟ್? ಯೆಸ್, ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಯು ವಿಶ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್, ಹೌ ಡ್ ಯು ವಿಶ್ ದೆಮ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಲೀವ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್? ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ ದ ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಲೀವಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್, ಹೌ ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ವಿಶ್ ಗುಡ್ ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್? ದಟ್ ಈಸ್, ಗುಡ್ ಬೈ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಸೀ ಯು ಟುಮಾರೋ. ಸಿಂಪಲ್, ಗುಡ್ ಬೈ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಸೀ ಯು ಟುಮಾರೋ. ಓಕೆ, ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್, ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಸೇ ಅಲೌಡ್. ಫೈಂಡ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪೋಯಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ರೈಮ್ ವಿತ್ these words. Okay, what is the rhyming words? Rhyming words are the similar sound in the ending. Do you understand? Ending is similar in sound. Two words having ending is similar in sound. Okay, find those words in this poem is, yes, sun, run, birds, trees, day away. Okay, here some bees, trees, day, away, to you. For bees, trees. This is the rhyming word for bees. Next, for day, away is the rhyming word. And for to you is the rhyming word. Do you understand? Next, second, what do you see around you during the day and night and at night? Draw into two boxes given below and color the picture. Okay. This work is for you students. Okay, you have to draw the diagram of day, the climate of day. Yes, the sun rises, the light is wide and rich, and it's spread all over the world, and the birds are flying here and there, right? This is the picture of dream. You have to write it and you have to color it. And it's night. There is a darkness everywhere and the moon appears and the stars will appear, right? This is the diagram of night and you have to write on it, color it, okay? And next, write two words each from the pictures you have drawn. Okay, what will you see in the day? Yes, you see sun, right? You see light, right? You see people, right? You see birds. Those are the words, those are the pictures, those are the words in your pictures. And nightly, and in night, you will see the stars, you will see the moon, you will see the galaxies, you will see the planets, right? You have to write down. Okay. Team time. Dinner. This is mud. A big fat worm lives in the mud. A leaf falls in the mud and it is the worm's dinner. Form groups, tell each other an interesting thing you have seen in the garden one day. Okay. This is for you guys. Next song time. There is a song. I like to sing when the sun is shining. Tra-la-la-la, tra-la-la-la. I like to sing when the sun is shining. Tra-la-la-la, tra-la-la-la. Like this. Okay. Some of the opposite words also here in this poem. Those are day. For day, it's the opposite word is night. For awake, the opposite word is asleep. For wide, the opposite word is narrow. And for the word gone, the opposite word is come. And also, for out, it is in. And for awake, it is asleep. Okay? These are the some of the opposite words in this poem. Okay. Hope all your exercises and this unit one poem, that is Good Morning, is completed and you understand this poem, right? If you have any doubts, you can ask me anywhere. And yeah, thank you so much.